Shall we get going?
Yeah, let's get going. So we're going to start by coming to mat. So coming to the top of your mat, hopefully you can still see me. And we're just going to think about our posture for a moment. So pulling up out of your hips, bringing the navel to the spine, ribs drawn downwards, thinking of legs sliding. Coming from the shoulders down, nice long neck. And we're going to take our shoulders up and back. So up. And rolling back, using the whole of the shoulder girdle. But then you're going to tuck the chin and move the head, rolling down through the spine, bending and coming back. We're going to repeat that again. So shoulder rolls for two. Tucking the chin all the way down and coming back. We're going to think about using every section of the spine. Tucking the chin, rolling back. And back. Good. Last two. And coming down. And final one. This time we're gonna stay down. We're going to roll down, and we're going to allow the body to hang down over the left. So keeping the stomach close to the thighs, head is really heavy. And we're just going to keep a plie bend of the knees and straighten and rise. Really, really getting those ankles nice and mobile. We're stretching at the back of the leg. Allow that upper body to be nice and heavy down over the left. Good. One more here. Good, and last one. Now we're going to walk the hands forward, coming to a downward dog. Allow the foot to kind of heels down to the floor. Good. And your ankle starts to get really warm. Last few here. Good. Now we're going to take the right leg up to the ceiling, splitting the legs apart. And we're going to breathe here for a few moments. Really think about stretching that foot, stretching the knee, make sure no stops move. If you want to pull the leg down to the floor. Bending that knee in on top, we're going to bend and point, and then stretch and pull the foot back out again. And we'll go again, point and bend. Good. And flex and straighten. Good. And again. Rethink about that heel on the leg is really pushed down to the floor. And bend and hold. Flex and straighten. Last few here. Keep breathing. Flex and straighten. We're going to take that leg down. Knee comes to the chest. Stretching forward into a lunge, making sure it's 90 degrees. And we're going to twist up towards the ceiling with the right hand. So we push our hands low to the ground, lovely long lines through the back of the heel as we come. Good. Alright, last few moves here. And bringing that right hand down to the mat, either side of that front foot. We're going to take the weight into the hands now, lowering that knee gently at the back to the floor, and then walking that foot across, lower down into the position. Finding the angle of the leg that works for you. So the closer that foot is to the body, the less intense the stretch, and the further away, the deeper the stretch. So find what's right for you, and then come down over that leg, just for a moment. Conscious, deep breaths. Good. those muscles on the outside of the body just relaxing into the floor, melting into the floor. Last breath here. And then coming back to come, taking your hands either side of your leg. So you're going to put that toe under at the back. We're going to take the weight back into the hands, coming back into down and up. Let's practice this move again. Working up the lovely long spines. Back to the leg. Good. Now we're going to bring that left leg up to the ceiling. Splitting the legs apart. And again, really rush to the top and make sure that those knees are soft. And then bending that knee on top and then flexing, straighten. Good. And bend the knee and flex and straighten. Good. This is a great way to open up the side of the back. It's really, really relaxed. Breathing and straighten, flex, flex, and good. Taking that knee into the flex, stepping forward into our lunge. Again, making sure that the front legs are 90 degrees and the hips are hanging nice and low to the ground. Twisting that hand up. Breathing. And keep that lovely long, elongated spine out to the top of the head. And moving in, taking that hand back to the mat. And again, taking the weight into the hand, we lower that knee at the back. And then lower that front leg down into our pigeon pose. Find the angle right for you, and then the last one, open the leg. You really allow this muscle to melt down into the floor. Breathe in, exhale. Good, turn back up, take the weight into the hands. And then pushing back one final time. Good. Padding through those feet. One last time before we move up. Good, and then lowering the knees down. We'll take you through to the next section.
Sorry, I've got music. I can hide in here. Just going to take my shoes off. Okay, so are you ready
to go? Yeah, I think you're still stuck, but it's fine. I can still see you.
So you can still see, you're fine. You can still see you too. Okay. So we're going to warm up the back a little bit first. So just follow the words that I'm using because it might seem a bit confusing this first sequence, but it's actually really simple. So we're going to come to a high plank, nice and strong, make sure that pelvis is in line. What we're going to do is we're going to bend the knees and push the body back. So we're pushing right into those shoulder blades. From here, you kind of come up through a downward dog. So push off those feet, straighten the legs. Then we roll through the spine, back down, and we drop those hips to an up dog. That's it. And then look up towards the ceiling. Keep those toes tucked underneath. Then we go again. So we push into the hands to high plank. We bend the knees back. Then we come up through a downward dog, roll through the spine, and drop the hips. Look up towards the ceiling. Again, squeeze that tummy. We push up, high plank. Bend the knees back. Through a downward dog and roll through the spine to an up dog. Look up towards the ceiling. We're going to do that a couple more times. So squeeze the tummy, high plank, bend the knees. Then we push up and we roll through the spine to an up dog. Look up towards the ceiling. Again, two more times, high plank, bend those knees, push up, roll through that spine, and drop the hips. Look up. Last time, really push into the hands, push into those shoulder blades, push off the feet, roll through the spine, and down. Good, from here, you're going to relax the legs on the floor. We're going to bend those knees and we're just going to send the body back. So we just relax the bum onto the heels and we just relax here. So make sure you keep breathing throughout the sequence. Deep breaths in through the nose and out through the mouth. We're going to push forward to an up dog again. This one goes a wee bit faster. And then we just come back to that starting position. Back on those legs. Make sure you really roll through the spine. And then the opposite way. Good, just keep going here. Four more. Nice. And fast, but controlled at the same time. Do one more for me. Good. Now come to a neutral position. So I want you to make sure that your knees are underneath your hips. What we're going to do is, I don't know what you call it, like an angry cat, happy cat, whatever it's called. But like a little bit differently, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to bend those elbows to touch the floor. So just let them tap to the floor. Then we're going to curve through the spine. So roll through the spine, tuck under, and straighten the arms. Then we bend the elbows back down, and we go the opposite way. So we curve the spine, we look up, and we straighten those arms. That makes sense. That's you. Just keep going through those two movements. We bend and we curve. Use the tummy muscles and contract through the belly. We bend and we reach up, fold into those arms. Again, keep going a couple more. Make sure you keep breathing in through the nose and exhale on your way down. Good. Give me three more. We bend. We curve up. We bend. We curve up. Good. Just enjoy the movement. It's nice and easy. One more here. We bend. We contract. We bend. We curve. Good. Now just bring your spine to neutral when you feel ready. What we're going to do is we're going to thread the arm through. So I want you to get your left hand. We're going to bend that right elbow as we thread the left hand through the gap. And just relax that left shoulder blade on the floor. Relax your head on the floor too. We take a deep inhale. And as we do that, we're going to unfold and we reach up towards the back at the left side. Just feel the twist through the chest and the back. When you get here, you're just going to twist that arm even further. Just fold it over the back if you can, just to open up those shoulders. Unfold the arm and then we fold back down to that original position. Just relax down. Deep breath in. And exhale, unfold. If you can, go a little bit deeper and just relax that hand down. We fold, we twist through that spine. We unfold the arm and we come back down, fold underneath. This is the last one here. Push up, open, and relax the arm. Twist that chest, and then come back to neutral. Good, same thing on the other side. You're gonna thread your right arm through this time. Fold underneath, relax that shoulder on the floor. Deep breath in, we exhale and we open up. And if you can, you drop that arm and twist through those shoulders. Unfold the arm and we come back down, thread through. And again, reach up. Relax the arm, feel the twist right through those shoulders. Open up that chest, unfold, and then we do one more. Fold underneath, we reach up, and we relax the arm. Really twist for that last one, and relax, just come to neutral. Good, so your shoulders, your back and your chest should feel a lot more open up now. We're gonna go into opening up those hips. So what I want you to do, I don't really know how to explain to get into this position, but if you can see me, we're trying to aim for a right angle at both kneecaps.
Is it right leg in front?
Go right leg in front. I've got left, but we're the same. That makes sense. So make sure you plant that, you're aiming to plant the back hip into the floor, but that might not be possible for all of us. So I want you to have a right angle at both knees. Your hands just come in front of you and you're gonna keep the back nice and straight. We're just gonna lean forward a tiny little bit into that front leg. And then we bring the hands back a little bit and we lean into the back hip. So if your hip wasn't down before, now's the time we push the hip into the floor. Keep that spine nice and long. We're just gonna go through those two movements. So we fold forward, back nice and straight, that front knee is planted into the ground. And then we fold back, plant the back hip into the floor. Not your hip. Good, and again, we fold forward. And we reach back. Good. Now when you're here, put your hands behind your hips. So they should, yeah, good. So I want you to think about opening up this back hip. So like the front hip here, if you can see me in this hip. We're gonna put the weight into this back foot and we're gonna open up that hip just slightly without moving anything else. And then we put it back down. So it might not open too far, but we're just aiming to get some mobility in those hips. So really put the weight in this back foot and then fold it back down. You should feel really tight in this area.
Yeah.
It's horrible, this stretch.
Those turnout muscles do not like this.
Yeah. They're non-existent anymore. Good, just keep going here. Last one. And back down. Good, now we're just gonna go to the other side. So just literally twist and change. You should be in the right position. Adjust if you need to, make sure you've got those right angles at both the kneecaps. Hands at either side. Again, keep that long spine. We fold forward into that front leg. Maybe even go a wee bit further forward so you feel the stretch in that glute. Hands back a little bit and we lean back into the back leg. So plant that glute into the floor and then we come forward again. Good. So keep the upper body nice and strong. We're not collapsing into the tummy or the back. We're just going through the two movements. Good. Do a couple more. We'll come forward. And then we'll come back. Okay, good. When you come back, put your hands behind those hips again. Weight into that back leg. Flex the foot if you need to, it might make it a little bit easier. We're opening up that hip, keeping everything else nice and still, and then we're closing it. So it won't open all the way, but we're just aiming to open it slightly. Good. Trying to keep that front knee on the floor as much as possible. It shouldn't feel very nice.
It doesn't.
No, it definitely doesn't.
But it's good though. Definitely.
You can feel it working, can't you?
Yeah.
Always nice. Good. Do a couple more here. Last one. Okay, now what I want you to do is bring your legs to the front or to the side, whatever direction you're facing. I'm going to go to the side because it might not be a very nice angle from the front. So lie down with your hips and your feet in line with your hips. Just relax your back onto the floor. You're going to open up those feet a little bit so the knees aren't out to the side. They're still facing up, but they're slightly wider. So like just out, on the outside of your mat, if you've got one, we're going to fold the knees to the one side. Just relax them on the floor. We're aiming to not lift that back hip off the floor. It will come off just slightly, but try to plant it down into the floor. And we're just going to change sides. We're just going to keep going through the movement and drop the knees from side to side. Good. You might not feel this very much, but you might feel it a lot. It just depends where you're tight and where you're loose.
Yeah.
Good. Give me four more. Four. Three. Two. And one. Good. Now what we're going to do is I want you to come up, just sit up slightly. This time make sure that your feet are in line with your hips. So if you need to just use your hands, brush down to make sure they're fully in line. Bring the feet in a little bit closer. So maybe like a foot distance between your bum and your heel. Bring your hands just below your shoulder blades or a tiny little bit further back. So I want you to flex those feet so the toes are off, the heels are planted on the floor. Actually, you might need to step them out a tiny bit further. So all the weight's in the heels. We're going to push into the heels and the hands to lift up those hips and then push the feet into the floor. So the whole foot's down now. And then we come back down, we flex those feet, lift the toes off, drop the heels. And tap the bum onto the floor. We're going to keep going through this movement. So we push up, toes tap the floor, heels are hips are up. We fold back down, lift those heels up, lift those toes off. Again, we push up through that chest, through the hips, and back down. So remember to engage your core, pull your belly button right through to your spine. Good, you should feel this working those arms as well. Give me three more. We push up and we relax down, lift those toes off. And we push off and we come down. Last one. Push up and relax. Good. Now we're over to you for the little stretch to finish us off.
Lovely.
Oh, we're actually pretty much, it's 27 minutes past, so.
Oh, perfect. I'm just literally going to put the legs out. We're just going to take a little stretch over with the right hand. It doesn't matter, you don't have to put in box fits or anything, just take the legs out, first of all, until you feel a light stretch on the inside of the legs. And we're just going to stretch the hands up and stretch over on the side, so keeping both hips as close to the ground as you can, just stretching out the side and breathing nice and deeply in the stretch. But the more you relax, the more you'll get out of the stretch. Good. And then coming back up, just going to reach over the other side. You should really feel the stretch all through the side.
Yeah. And it moves up to my least favorite position.
You twist both shoulders, kind of thinking chest towards the ceiling. You deepen the stretch even more. Good. And then coming back up. We're just going to take the soles and feet together. Just sit really, really high on your sit bones. Elongate the spine out through the top of the head. Lovely long neck. Shoulders gently being drawn downwards. And we're just going to relax the knees out. Making sure you're sitting high on those sit bones. We're just going to breathe deeply here for a moment. Really think about opening up those hips. You can gently push them slightly down to the floor if you want to increase the stretch. Good. And then, Lucy, do you want to finish off?
Okay. So we're just going to finish off with a little breathing sequence. So cross your legs just normally, come to a comfortable position. You're going to put your fingers are tapped on the floor, your palms are facing the front. You're going to lengthen through the spine so don't collapse into the body. Pull up and out of those ribs. So close your eyes if you need to. We're going to take a deep inhale. So we're going to breathe in, the arms come up and they meet at the top. And then we're just going to throw the breath out. So we go, good. But when we do that, don't collapse, okay? So we're just going to do those a few more times. So hands come out. We breathe in, together, and exhale. Don't be afraid to use your breath. Breathe in. Good, we'll do a few more just to finish off. Breathe in. Really fill your lungs as you bring the hands up. Last one, close your eyes, breathe in. Good, and just relax. Move the shoulders, do what you need to do. And that's us finished. Perfect, that was bang on. Bang on half an hour we got there.
Amazing. That was so nice. I feel mobilized.
Yeah, me too, actually. I had such a sore back before we started that. I feel good now.
Amazing.
Perfect. To anyone that joined in with us, if you've got a request or anything that you would like to do, then we'll probably do a few more of these. So just message either of us and we will be sure to do that.
Perfect. If there's anything that you want us to do, just ask, because we're dying to do more of these. But thank you for joining, guys.
Thank you, Ellie. Thanks for joining. Great. Thank you to everyone that joined us, and we shall see you soon.
Yes.
Bye, guys. Bye, Ellie. See you.
Bye. See you.